Everyone, this is MC Nandini Aravindan again today. So today's topic will be a little discussion oriented. So in case you have some doubts or something, you know, you get to get to your mind when we are discussing, do drop in your comments here, and I'll be happy to reply to all your comments. And as you all know, today's topic is about the 10 easy ways to improve your appearance. I hope it will be interesting, because people always judge by someone's appearance. But please do not do that. That's not the right way to judge someone. Only when you get to know someone by in person, when you go meet and you talk to them, you would know what they actually is all about. You know, what is their character, and how how do they respond to people, or how do they feel when someone approaches them. And it's all because it's all completely psychology based. So try to mingle with people, talk with them, and then decide about their character. Even then, even just by one or two conversations, you might not know what they really is, right? Okay. So I think I have gone live. Yeah. Yes, perfect, right? Okay, good. So before that, I was trying to do something. Let me just check if I'm doing the live in FB group as well. Yes, I'm doing it. Okay, so fine. So as I told today, it's going to be more like a discussion. So let me just let me just tell you what is appearance, and the basic things that is needed to impress or to make someone really feel good when they talk with you. Okay, those are the points that we're going to discuss with each other today. Okay, well, I think there's some problem. One second. I hope all good. Yes. So, fine. So, the appearance of a person. Okay, yesterday, let's just quickly go through what we discussed yesterday. So, the yesterday's topic was positive affirmation, right? So, I hope people who have joined yesterday or liked my video yesterday or had a discussion in comments. I hope you people have already started implementing it. Yes, if so, please do comment here. I'll be really very happy to hear those beautiful comments from you, because I wanted everyone to practice that. So it's not just I say and I don't do. I always do whatever I preach. So that's the reason why I also did it very religiously today, because I had to come and say to you guys, right, that I have done that. So generally, even when I travel, or whenever I feel lonely, or I feel alone, or somewhere I'm just getting myself aloof, I used to do this. I used to practice positive affirmations, and I should say that today morning, that it was like I woke up with all energy, with full excitement, and I did preached those things. I did practiced. Sorry, I did practiced. Those beautiful affirmations, positive affirmations, like I do every day. And I also do some spiritual works once I wake up. So I also continued that. So I was feeling really very good and very happy and very energetic. I hope you must have also felt those kind of emotions. Well, okay, let's get into the topic today. I'm myself, and before that, I'll just give a small intro about myself. I'm MC Nandini Aravindan. As you all know, I'm an anchor by profession, and also I have experience in singing, dancing, and classical, western, hula hoop dancer, and also I'm a model. And I do paint, I do handicrafts, and all such things as my hobby. Well, okay, I'm part of Chennai Event MCs, as you all know, I'm the co-founder of Chennai Event MCs, and I pay my gratitude to my guru and my business partner, MC Tamilarasan, and I also pay my gratitude to my mentor, Dr. Maharaja Sivasubramaniam, and I also pay my gratitude to my another business partner, Simana. Thank you so very much to all three of you for supporting me all this while. It's just because of my mentor and my guru I'm here today, and I would like to thank in every video and pay my gratitude and extend my thanks. Thank you so very much. I thank the Almighty for finding me such beautiful souls, and get them here to me, and as they mentored me, as they trained me, I'm here today and conversing with you, as I always say. So thank you so much. I'm happy and I feel blessed. Thank you. So let's quickly, without further ado, get into the topic. So 10 easy ways to improve your appearance. Well, okay, the appearance of a person is like, two-sided facet. It is something that the person in question does with himself or herself. But at the same time, it is what he or she creates. That is the first, the most important thing. That's nothing but the first impression. So, most of the people limit appearance to just, looking good. It's not that. But I don't completely agree with that. Okay, it is true that over time, we human beings, have learned to place more faith in our own sense of vision. But the fact remains that, our senses are very much alive and play a major role, maybe even subconsciously, in the, perception of others. So we just, think that, the sense of our vision, we play a very, we keep them a very, or we give them a very higher perception. We keep them in a very higher perception, the senses. And we don't know that, even subconsciously our mind works on something else. So that is what, we have to concentrate. The next thing is, before getting into more of technical stuff, improving one's appearance need not, involve expensive treatments or therapies. You need not have to do that. It doesn't, literally work on your face, the skin, or the way you look. No, it doesn't even require any treatments or any therapies. It all begins with minor basic changes in your daily life. So let's see what are all those simple steps that has to be taken into account to appeal to others. Okay, well, the first thing that you need to follow to improve your appearance is the body fitness. You might be laughing, what is that all about? Is she talking about body fitness? Yes, I'm so sorry for that, but yes, you had to I had to talk about that and you had to listen to it. Okay, and it's no secret that a fitter body appeals more to the human eye. Yes or no? Yes. But nevertheless, every body type can be accentuated to look the best it possibly can, because lots of factors like color, the shape, cut, length, and patterns need to be taken into consideration. And dressing according to your body type helps to hide the flaws and bring out some positive things in your appearance. Okay. Also, a keen eye for color combination. Whatever you wear, or whatever you dress, or whatever you paint, or something like that. The color combination that work well helps a great deal actually to look. Okay. So body fitness is very, very important, because when a human being, when two people like very fat guy or very a very fit and a fat guy stands next to each other, obviously your eyes will get attracted towards the one who has a fit physique, right? Yes. So we have to concentrate on that to appear really good. And second thing is, I would say, okay, these are all my personal suggestions and personal perception So it's not that, you know, I should be correct, but these are all my views and perceptions. So if I, you know, if you have some controversies, if you have some contradictions as well, sorry, contradictions, you can post in as your comments, because that's not gonna be you know, offending or offensive to me. It's just that I can learn from you. That's it. Okay? I don't you know, I don't get into controversies. So please do not, you know, fake some, you know, comments. It's not that, you know, you need to really comment on that. If you have something good, just go ahead, write on as a comment. Okay? And yes, the second thing is, the first thing was the body type, the body fitness. Okay? And second thing I would say is good haircut. So picking a haircut, you know, that suits you is more difficult than it is, you know, made out to be. Because this is one situation where simply following fades can lead to some disastrous results. You know, maybe you can, you might, you know, color your hair, but that doesn't suit you, and so it might, you know, look disastrous. So the most important factor to consider is the shape of the face, shape of your face. You know, because most importantly, I should say, like, you know, the shape of your face is obviously it's always the same. You cannot alter it, but at least the haircut can be altered according to your face shape. Say for example, oval face, right? This shape is considered the most ideal, and because the most of the hairstyles will easily suit to oval faces. But remember that, you know, if you have very heavy bangs, you know, on the front, heavy, very heavy bangs, and uneven haircut, that doesn't look good actually. So, but otherwise, you know, if you have some fringes, very mild fringes, or any other kind of, you know, laser cut or feather cut, or layers, anything that would really suit well, or curls, something like that. Okay? And okay, so I think I have got some messages. Okay, live isn't working in on my profile, it's going only on my group. Okay, I'll just check on that. I'll just check. Is that so? I'm really surprised. Okay, just give me a minute, or just give me less than a minute. I'm gonna check on the live. Okay, I think live is playing. And is there a problem? Is there a problem? Okay. Tamil has messaged me saying, like, there's a problem in my live. Okay. Okay, let me just check once. Okay, so I think I have to start again. Okay, fine. I'll do that. I'll do that. Okay, let me just check till when I was audible, or I was there. Okay, finish it off. So I'm gonna finish this video and post it. Okay, done. So that is it. I'm gonna rejoin again in my profile. Sorry for that. Just give me a minute again. So let me just join here. And okay, so I think I have lots of messages. Consider the shape of face, shape of your face. Okay, so I have posted this. Okay, here we go. going it for the second time in my profile. I don't know, there was some problem. I'm seriously unaware of that problem. And thank you, Tamil, for letting me know. And alright, here we go. And this is my live. For people who are watching me, hi. People who are watching me on my profile, sorry, there was some problem, technical problem, and I had to leave the live and rejoin again. Okay, so I was talking about the face shapes, right? So in that case, oval face is considered the ideal for most. No, I wasn't able to receive any comments. Yeah, I wasn't able to receive any comments on my profile. Okay. So people, if you had tried posting some comments, please do come and join this and you can post your comments. Well, I hope you know this live is going well. Alright, yeah, I can see two eyes was watching me, thank you. Well, yes, as I already said, I'm just repeating this point for the third time, I'm sorry. Alright, it's working perfect right now, thank you. Good. The old face, you know, is considered to be the ideal for most of the hairstyles. So please avoid the hairy bangs and uneven hairstyles for old face. So the first is body fitness, and the second is a good haircut. Third is, you know, your mannerisms. Your mannerisms account for a lot. They include the way you walk, the way you sit, the way you stand, even gesture. And the confidence, you know, the confidence inspires the best mannerisms, I would say. Confidence, you know, okay, what do you want? Maybe quickly you can recap in a minute where you, okay. Alright, I was just speaking about the 10, as I already mentioned, the 10 ways to improve your appearance. The first way is to make sure that you have a fit body. So body fitness is very, very important. Go for a gym. Do some workout, do some yoga, do some aerobics, or go for a Zumba fitness, or come to me, I'll train you with hula hoop, and that's gonna get you very, very slim and trim belly. So all these kinds of stuff you can follow. That is my first point. So the second point of mine is, like, you know, you should have a good haircut. So try to have a good haircut, because that will, you know, enhance your confidence again. And try to select a haircut that, you know, suits your face, because as I said, you know, some of the faces will not have the best haircuts, but they have a best face shape. You know, like, you know, oval is the best face shape. That's the most, you know, I should say ideal face shape, because most of the haircuts will suit. But some of the haircuts, like, you know, heavy bangs or uneven haircuts, will not suit oval face. And if it's going to be very round face, you can go for some, you know, feather cuts, like, you know, where you can have heavy bangs. That's going to be looking really good, because that will, you know, make your face look thinner, and so the round shape might, you know, be hidden. So kind of, you can just go for the hair stylist, experienced hair stylist expertise, to go for get a suggestion and get a good haircut. Okay, the second thing is haircut. I was talking about haircut. And the third thing I was about to discuss was the mannerisms. So mannerisms accounts for a lot of, you know, things. They include the way you sit, where you walk, where you stand, where you project yourselves, where you show the gestures, etc. So confidence, you know, inspires the best mannerisms, I would say. I just stopped with that point, I suppose. Yes. Because you tend to act the way you feel most comfortable, right? And that confidence is clearly visible to anyone who is watching you. So please be very confident while you're walking, you're sitting, or, you know, even when you're talking to someone else, or when you're gesturing someone else, be confident enough to, you know, project yourself. And that's gonna be, like, really good when someone, you know, sees you, when someone comes and meets you for the first time, when someone greets you, just go give them a very firm handshake. That would really, you know, exhibit your confidence level. And when you sit straight and when you sit confidently, that will, you know, give them a very, very good first impression. So make yourselves very comfortable with all your mannerisms. Okay, so do not do something like, you know, when you're talking to someone else, do not scratch your head, or, you know, scratch somewhere, or, you know, just don't fiddle with your mobiles. Don't bite your nails. Don't do that, you know, because that's gonna spoil your appearance again. So avoid all those things, okay? And the next point I would say is about the sitting posture. You know, while you are facing someone or while you're talking to someone in a sitting posture, please you know, follow these things. You know, some of the you know simple don'ts includes, you know, looking at ground while walking or while sitting. So do not look at the ground while walking. That will, you know, you know, imply that, you know, you're not confident enough while walking somewhere, you know, wherever you're walking, in the place, in a public place, or even in event, or even in a public gathering. Do not walk while just seeing down. Okay, that's gonna really, you know, give someone else a bad impression. Not a bad impression, probably I should say, like, you know, I should put it in this way, that will not impress them well, and that will lower your confidence as well, you know. And while you're sitting, do not hunch yourself. Okay, hunchback is gonna be like really bad, I should say. And the most importantly, do not fiddle with your fingers or fiddle with your clothing, okay? And have a good eye contact. That's more important. That's very, very important. Have a very good eye contact while speaking to someone else. Someone, you know, probably in person, or while speaking to a crowd, while addressing a crowd, whatever it is. Try to have some eye contacts, regular eye contacts. You know, that will boost your confidence, and that will make someone else to think that you are really confident. Okay, and the exact opposite of you know, these is what makes, you know, for a good impression. That is, you know, you should not hunch. Okay, so if you hunch your back, that's really gonna give bad impression. And do not fiddle with your fingers, and do not fiddle with your clothing. Maintain a good eye contact, and walk by having a very mid-level eye contact. Do not sit down, nor do not look up, okay? That's going to boost your confidence very well. So walk straight, upright, with your eyes at mid-level. Sit up straight, and lean back if you want. You know, you can always lean back. If you have a very comfortable seating, like sofa or something else, you can definitely lean back. And but never hunch forward, okay? Leaning back is different and hunching forward is different, okay? So do not hunch forward, and maintain a very good eye contact. Feel totally comfortable in whatever position you are. That is more important. Okay? When you're comfortable, your confidence will raise up automatically. Okay? And the fifth point is, okay? Okay, the fifth point is about, yes, cleanliness of your nails. Okay? Cleanliness of your nails. Apart from the more, you know, obvious aspects of your clothes or hair, it is very important to pay attention to your toe and fingernails. So not only do long nails look bad, sometimes, you know, the long nails might look a little bad, okay? That is not properly shaped. That's more important. If your long nails is not properly shaped, and that's gonna really look bad. So shape it well. And the most important thing is the dirt that collects underneath your nails. You know, the dirt that collects underneath your nails, although minimal, you know, it reflects a very poor sense of hygiene, I would say. You know, even if there's going to be a little, you know, black mark or something, you know, underneath your nail, that will reflect a very, very poor sense of hygiene. So try to avoid that. Try to clean your nails regularly, at least twice a week. And if it's going to be, you know, females, you know, all the females who are watching, you know, you need not have to always, you know, paint your nails. At least you can just maintain a very good hygiene by having a very clean nails, you know, without dirt. That would really impress people, you know, when you greet them, when you give them hands, you know, that will really boost your confidence as well. So for all the females, it's not necessary that you always have to shape your nails and paint your nails, but please keep your nails in proper shape, you know, proper levels. It's not that shape is important, the levels are important. And also it should be very, very clean. And for all the men, yes, obviously, please take care of the cleanliness. You know, you should try to remove the dirts every at least once or twice in a week, okay? And that will reflect the sense of hygiene. Okay, and the sixth point, I suppose. Yes, sixth point is the most important thing, that is the body order. Okay, body order, you know, some people might not feel comfortable when, you know, discussing all these things, but I don't feel, you know, odd for discussing this, because this is like, you know, bringing people to awareness state. So people might know, but that they might not, you know, follow that. But some people might not even know that, oh no, there's a factor like this. So I'm just bringing some awareness. So here's what the sixth point says. Yes, body order. So some critics, you know, this point I wanted to stress. Some critics are there around us, you know, and as everyone knows, some critics are revolving around us. Critics, in the sense, I'm saying some people who critics about others, you know, critics might forgive a bad sense of clothing. They might even, you know, forgive a bad sense of clothing. But a smell that puts one off is very hard to erase from their memory. I hope you understand. Okay, some critics, you know, might even forgive your bad sense of clothing or bad attire, shoes or whatever accessories. But the smell, you know, that puts one off is like very hard to erase from one's memory. So please take care of the body order. Please, you know, use some good perfumes or good body spray, or even, you know, you can carry some. Always, you know, my handbag will always have some perfumes. So just, you know, in case if you go out and if you sweat, you can always, you know, wear that anytime. And that's really important. It could be the result of something you ate. You know, the body odor can be something, you know, the result of something, you know, you ate just before. Might be onions or some, you know, something like garlic, something like that. Or a recent, you know, workout. You have just worked out and you're just going all with all sweat to some, you know, place, some public gathering or somewhere. So that will really create some bad odor, right? And, you know, yes. So the first thing was something that you ate. The second thing was due to some workout, okay, the recent workout. And third thing might be because of poor hygiene, okay. So please take care of the body odor, and whatever the cause, banish the odor with some perfume or something, okay. So you must have basic hygiene, and you have to take care of the most, you know, problematic things that you face, okay, for yourself. It differs from person to person. Wash your mouth immediately after you eat, okay? Immediately after you eat, just wash your mouth, gargle something, and, you know, you can just gargle water and spit it out, so that, you know, you remove all the odor out of your mouth. At least, you know, you can just save for the time being. And have a good shower after your workout. That's more important. Lather up with a very good shower gel that you know, regularly use. And if you feel that, you know, that is not effective, just try to change some other product and see if it is very, you know, fragrance full, and if it's smelling really good, no, just go for something else, okay? Some products that, you know, really smells good. And yes, so the body odor has to be taken care, and most important thing is, like, you know, you have to choose the right perfume or right shower gel for your body, in order to bring that or in order to banish the odor and bring that fragrance, okay? Yes. So the seventh point will be, okay, I think I have completed 6 points, and the seventh point will be clothing odor. The clothes might generate some odor. Yeah, who knows, you know, even in the winter season, if the clothes are not drying properly, you will definitely get some odor in your clothing. So please pay attention to that. So the another aspect of, you know, odor factor include, you know, the clothes and your accessories too. Your accessories also pays, you know, or also create some smell, some odor. And most importantly, jeans can withstand multiple uses, but avoid doing the same with other clothes as well. So it can be a very usual pant, or it can be a trek. So please don't, you know, encourage wearing that twice or thrice, just like what you do with your jeans, okay? A gentle wash with your very light or fragrance detergent gives that freshness to your clothes. So try doing that at least once a week. Just wash the clothes after your use. Some people, you know, they feel very tired or lazy for washing their clothes. So at least you have to have a schedule where you have to wash at least once in a week all your clothing and dry it, sun dry it. It's very important to sun dry your clothes. And during winter times, yes, no one can help, can help you, because you can, you cannot find sun. Sometimes, you know, it's going to be like really tough on those days. I agree, but at least you can just dry it outside on your balcony or something, somewhere like that, you know. So sun dry it and use some fragrant detergent, or you can also use something like, you know, Comfort, the conditioners that is available, clothing conditioners, cloth conditioners that is available. So do something like that, okay. And do not ignore even the tiniest smudges of your clothing. You can iron it, wear it after, you know, pressing it, and you will have a very crisp look when you wear the clothing, okay. So kindly take attention to your clothes as well. So cloth order is also very important, like the body order. So please try to banish it, avoid it, okay. And the eighth point that I would like to discuss is about foot order. Okay, foot. Foot order is a very common problem most of them would face. Best ways to tackle your foot order is regular washing and scrubbing of your feet to remove all those, you know, dead cells and calluses. So this is very important. You have to at least once or twice in a month you just get your pedicure done, at least by yourself. You need not have to go for a salon to get that done. If you are really very good and if you are having good wallet full, then you can really go for a pedicure. But all you can do is, you know, you can even try the same with your inside your bathroom. That is, you know, you can go have a tub full of water, just wash your legs using some, you know, shower gel or something. Remove all the calluses and dead cells with a scrub. And, you know, this can be done at least once in a week, you know, in order to make sure that your dead cells and calluses are removed completely, okay. And and drying your feet is very important actually. After your bath, just dry it for some time. Before drying it, just don't step outside, you know, collect all the dust again. No, do not do that. So especially between your toes. So between your toe fingers, there's going to be the areas wherein all the fungal infections, you know, all the bacterial infections would start generating. So try to avoid that. And use a very thicker socks, that I should say, I forgot. Use a very thicker socks, and that absorbs all the sweat. Because people who sweat a lot can use thicker socks to, you know, absorb the sweat. But remember to change them regularly, you know. At least if you are using the socks for one full day, do not use the same socks for the next day, okay. And sprinkle some talcum powders, you know. Sprinkle some talcum powders inside your shoes. That will, you know, literally bring some good smell, okay. And also put some perfume on your socks, which will reduce the odor, you know. You can avoid the odor or the smell that generates after the sweat when you remove your shoes or socks at the end of the day. So try to do this, try to, you know, implement by sprinkling some talcum powders or, you know, spraying some perfumes kind of stuff, okay, to your shoes and socks. So try this. And last but one point, that is the ninth point, I suppose. Yes, the ninth point is the most important. Just pay a little more attention. Okay, hearing and feeling. So this is very important. Even the most well dressed and a pleasant smelling man or woman will not be accepted as a kind person in the society if he or she uses a very harsh word. Do you agree with me? Yes, yes, I know that, because that's universal truth. The most well dressed, pleasant looking, and very beautiful women or a very handsome man, if they say something very disrespectful, if they use some harsh words, will they be considered as a very kind person in the society? Not at all, right? So in order to do that, kindly, you know, limit the usage of words. Probably you can just, the harshness is not limited to the language used, but also pertains to the tone in which you address another person. So the tonality is very important. Okay, harshness is like, you know, it is not determined just by the language. You can even say hello in different tones. Hello, hello, hello. So all these kinds of, you know, tonality differs from person to person. And please pay attention to that. Okay, when you address someone, when you talk to them for the first time, be very pleasant. Even for the second time, even for when you talk to them multiple times, do not, you know, raise your voice, nor, you know, the tone has to be maintained in a very, very pleasant manner. That's when, you know, people will consider that you are really very pleasant and you're very kind. Okay? And many people will judge others based on how they treat people inferior to them. You know, that's very, very important. So you try to judge someone when they treat people who are inferior to them, and how they treat people who are inferior to them. That's how you judge the person, right? If there's a teacher and if there's a peon in that school, if she's treating that peon in a very unpleasant manner, will that teacher be considered good? Not at all. That teacher will not be considered as a pleasant or a kind person, right? So please treat the people who are inferior to you in a very, very pleasant manner. So that's going to determine your character. So when people, you know, start judging you by seeing your character, and if you do so, that's going to be a very, very great black mark, I should say. It's going to be, sorry, not great. It's going to be very, very upsetting thing, I should say. Okay? So do not do that. And for example, being nice to a waiter, even, you know, being nice to a waiter in a hotel might seem insignificant to us or to you, but it adds more value to your overall image. Am I correct? See, for example, if you're going to a hotel and if you're addressing a waiter saying, "Could you please, you know, get me a menu card?" That is really pleasant. But when you address him like, "Get me a menu card," that's not going to be pleasant, you know, and that's going to degrade your image for that particular moment. So that's not going to add value to your image. So please pay attention to the hearing, feeling, the touching, all these senses, you know, when you approach people, and also especially new people, because that's going to give you more credits. Okay? And last point to be discussed on this platform, on this topic, do not overuse hand gestures. Do not overuse hand gestures and facial expressions. Some people might, you know, talk in a manner like something like that. So do not do that, okay? Just be pleasant, be who or whatever you are, and do not imitate someone else. When you try to imitate someone else, that's not going to work out. You have to be yourself always. So your words should be enough to express your emotions in most of the situations. So the usage of the words, if it is really very good and pleasant, if it's going to be really, it's going to be really convincing, people doesn't need any expression or people doesn't need any gesture. But yes, usage of a gesture and facial expression is very, very mandatory at many circumstances, but not at all the circumstances, okay? So there's a difference. Usage of words, gestures and hand gestures and facial expressions are very important, but it's not mandatory on all the situations. Okay, so try to avoid unnecessary gestures and facial expressions. So excessive gesturing shows lack of confidence in oneself and a craving for attention. So that is one bad thing that people would see, or people might, perceive from the way you, you act or you talk to them. Because when you show some faces or facial expressions, that is not prompt for that particular situation, that's going to be really unpleasant for the people who are watching, right? So try to avoid those facial expressions and hand gestures, okay? Fine, so I'm going to wrap up. And oh my goodness, that's 24 minutes. Okay, I'm going to quickly wrap up all the points. I think I'll be correct on the order. on the order, not disorder. Okay. First one was the body fitness. Okay. The first one was body fitness. Second was having a good haircut. Okay. That's very important. And third thing was the mannerisms. So your mannerisms accounts for a lot. Okay. And fourth thing was your sitting position. Okay, the sitting position. And yes, fifth thing was cleanliness of your nails. Okay, of your nails. Cleanliness of your nails. Sixth thing was about the body order. Right? The body order. Seventh was about the clothing order. So sometimes your clothes might even generate some odor. So about that we discussed. Eighth was about foot odor. Okay, your feet might generate odor, might not. It is like, you know, very common problem. So try to avoid that. So foot odor. And ninth point was about the touch, feel, hearing, senses, right? The respecting the new person. And the tenth, the last point was about the hand and facial gestures. Okay, so these were these are all the, you know, points that was discussed in today's topic. I hope it will be useful for everyone. I may even go on for a live in Tamil. Okay, for the people who usually request me to do the same, you know, topic in Tamil, I will definitely do it before tonight. Okay, and I just got one important message. Let me just address that. That is, okay, I think there are so many messages, so I can't address right now. Probably, yes. What I'll do is, like, I'll quickly respond to your comments. And the next live will be done by Tamir, my guru and mentor. Sorry, my guru and my business partner, MC Tamir Arasil. So he's going to do a live at 11:15 p.m. tonight. So going to talk on the social media marketing tips which he has learned in these 5 years. These 5 years, spending nearly thousands and thousands and nearly 2 lakh. So he is going to give you those tips. So please be please watch his live at 11:15, because that's going to be really useful. Because as a student, as his student, I'm going to watch it. Though I have been, you know, mentored and trained by him for years together, I still watch, because that's going to be a reinforcement for me, and that is going to make me move forward, and that's going to be like a revising once again. You know, it's just a brushing up my mind. So I'm going to watch his live at 11:15 p.m. So please join me watching his live. And that will be really interesting, because social media marketing tips are for free. Okay, so try to grab those tips and make the most of out of it. And that, this is MC Nandini Aravindan signing off. Okay. Before that, please do follow this these tips. And in case you are following it, do let me know that you had gained some knowledge and you have used it and you have gained good good things around you. So please do share your comments and share your experiences. I hope, you know, people must have started following positive affirmations. And likewise, do follow the 10 tips that I have shared. If it is really, you know, useful for you, and if you think that is going to work out for you, please do use that. So thank you so very much to all the good souls, to all my friends, and to all my supporters for watching this live. I'm really grateful to all of you. Thank you so very much. This is MC Nandini Aravindan signing off. Good night and stay blessed. Bye-bye.